Let's talk about Tropic. Innocent Tropic. Just there, isn't it, in the background? It's no harm to anyone. It's very wholesome, isn't it? The products are very good, aren't they? Really good. Really good products. Everyone says it. Really good products. So, I was quite confused because I thought to myself, well, that's an amazing company. Surely they wouldn't be threatened by people making critical videos about them, would they? And that's why I was very surprised when I found out that Suzanne Maher was contacting people who had spoken negatively about Tropic, negative reviews, not necessarily even negative reviews, mildly critical reviews, and essentially telling them to remove those reviews. Remove them. I find that an absolute disgrace. An absolute disgrace when you phone somebody and tell them you don't like what they've written and attempt to manipulate them into your way of thinking to protect your business model. That is predatory. And tell them to take something down. Just because you're such a lovely person, you wouldn't do anything to hurt anyone. So I decided, in that case, maybe I should do a video because I certainly won't be taking my Tropic videos down. I certainly won't be. I have a Tropic rep on my Facebook now and I am on her group, right? I know this woman. I know this woman. And I know the target market for you, Tropic. I know what it is. So, with most products, every product that they sell, every service, what the company does is they define a target market, and that is who are we aiming these products at? Who are we aiming this at? We've got fitness drinks, energy drinks. We're aiming them at the fitness market. A mug with a cat's face. We're aiming it at cat lovers. We do it with a cat's face on it, and then all the cat lovers will buy it. That kind of thing. So, Tropic and other MLMs, their target market isn't the end consumer of the products. That is one target market. But the main target market for an MLM is the reps. What kind of people are they going to attract to be their reps? Because that's where they get their money from. That's who pays them. The tiny sales that these reps make to the pity purchases and the embarrassing sales that these reps make to family members, who feel sorry for them, they're irrelevant. It's the reps that are buying the main stuff. They're the consistent purchasers, being the product of the product. They have to buy it all, don't they? And make the videos. So, what I believe with Tropic, and this is based on only my own observations. None of this is fact, this is purely my own observations. I feel like Tropic goes for suburban housewives, the middle classes. They don't target, their target market is not the, single mum struggling to make ends meet. They take her. I wouldn't say no to her. Take anyone. But that's not who they're targeting in every way. I mean, you just look at the joining fee, £198. It's not going to be affordable for somebody struggling to that extent. But, if you can afford that, like all things, I can afford that. I'm good enough to become a Tropic ambassador. I can afford that. Same with Temple Spa. They go for that same market and it's far, far, far more niche because somebody in this situation may not have the same incentive. It may not be as financially motivated. But as I've learned through researching this for the past 7 months, financial motivation is a tiny part of this. A bigger part of this is down to community, being involved with something, having a purpose. It's all very much more psychological than it is financial. And the people, as I said, that I I see that do stick in these things so much more are people who are motivated more by a psychological reason, a psychological need. And I think that that's very much what it will be with, and listen, let's not get this wrong. Just because somebody considers themselves to be, say, middle class or upper class, we know in this country that has nothing to do with money. You can be, you can be bloody, be a lord and not have a penny to your name, and you can be, consider yourself working class and be a multimillionaire. So it's not about that. It's about perceptions. It's about your ideas about things in this country. So Tropic appeals to, suburban housewives, mums, perhaps they haven't needed to work after their child was born. So they want to make friends, just want to be part of it. Perhaps they worked for years. They want to be part of it. They want to do something. Perhaps they do need the money. I mean, there's this idea that they don't need the money. Perhaps they do need the money, but they don't want people to think that they need the money. They're just, it's wellness. Like, it's just about wellness with me. I'm a wellness coach, and I just want to spread my wellness vibes around everywhere. But really, they probably could do with the money, because people from these backgrounds, they don't want people to know they need money, and they also don't want people to know when they're being scammed. And that's probably the biggest reason why we hear very, 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 very little about people who have been in Tropic and lost a load of money. And I'm hoping after this video, all that's going to change. Because as people who are subscribed to me and who follow me know, I very rarely just make one video about a company. That I'm hoping that people get in touch all anonymously and tell me their Tropic experiences. What happened to you? Tell me if you feel like you were scammed. If you feel like you were scammed, tell me, because we can stop others from being scammed like this. Because Tropic love to give this impression that they are so, 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 so wholesome, when the reality is your business model is predatory, right? You run a multi-level marketing business model. It is predatory by nature. It doesn't matter how amazing your products are, right? It doesn't matter how much your ambassadors go around with big smiles on their faces saying how wonderful they think they are, because I've just told you that's there. They're those people, right? They're those people that are never going to tell you when something's wrong. They don't want to give a perception that something's wrong in their life. That's your target market, right? So they say on the website, we don't go for people who have got followings of over 5,000. No, you don't go for people with followings over 5,000, because that's not your target market. You don't want people who will admit to liking celebrities, reality stars. You don't want those people. They might secretly like them, but you don't want people that openly admit that they follow reality stars, because again, that's not your target market. You want, you want this lady. You want my Facebook. You want my friend. You want her. She is typical. And I go on her page and I realise, now this lady, I'm not going to put her page anywhere near here. She's Sue Arbonne. Because Arbonne's another one. That's the same target market. Not sure about America, but this country. Same target market. They go for, and again, Arbonne isn't even that expensive to join, but it's Arbonne, wellness. About wellness, it's this idea of wellness and treating yourself in spas, isn't it? That's the, it's not knockoff perfumes. No. Not knockoff perfumes. We can afford the real perfumes. We just like Tropic because it's all natural skincare and it's really good for your skin. The products are really good. Now, Suzanne Marr didn't, who is the brains behind Tropic. She started this back in 2004 when she was only 15. It's brilliant, isn't it? She went on The Apprentice. She didn't win The Apprentice. Alan Sugar still decided to invest in her anyway in 2011. Now, in that room over there is Alan Sugar's biggest fan. So when I said to him about Tropic, my husband, he said, there's no way Alan Sugar knows. He doesn't know the truth about these schemes He won't know the truth about these schemes. He's, you know, he's a businessman. He'll have been told that we'll do this and gone along with it without really realising. I don't really think that's true. I think he knew full well, and I think he does know full well what the multi-level marketing model entails. And I think that after 2 years of no growth, no sales, because Tropic is in a completely and utterly saturated market, I think that's why in 2013, Tropic decided to pursue a multi-level marketing model. Instant customers, isn't it? Why didn't you carry on going down a normal business model? Why didn't you do the same as other companies who don't use multi-level marketing business models? You had a man who probably has connections everywhere. Could have got you in shops. And I remember what you said on your thing. We wanted the consumers to sell them. No. You have a person, a director of this company with connections all over the freaking world, right? Could have got those products into shops. Could market those products, right? But you've gone down this business model. Let me tell you why. Because your products can't compete. Your products, regardless of how good they are, regardless of how award-winning they are, regardless of how natural they are, cannot compete in a normal marketplace. They can't do it. There is too much competition for your products by equally good products. So your products cannot compete in a normal market. You put your products on the shelves of Boots for the price that you've got them on for, nobody's gonna pick them up. Nobody. They would probably if you did what was necessary for a legitimate business model to do marketing-wise, which is to spend millions on marketing. And for the target, for your target market, and we're gonna presume now that, forget about reps, just your target market, if you want to sell skincare products for that for that price, your target market needs to be people with a few quid. You would need to then use celebrities who would appeal to people with a few quid. Classy celebrities, A-list celebrities, not reality stars. You wouldn't be able to go on, you wouldn't be able to pay somebody on Instagram, you know, to put a picture with your product, some reality stars. That's not going to sell. It's not going to sell your product, is it? Those kind of influencers. So you know that, and could you afford to do that as a company? Would it even yield you enough? Would you guarantee that you would make the relevant sales to justify such a massive investment? I don't think so. I don't think so because there are too many products in the market now that are equally as good as yours, if not better. And your target market, it's saturated already with high-end brands, you know, saturated, absolutely saturated with high-end brands. You cannot compete, and that's why you went down this business model. But I'm going to tell you now, Suzanne, this business model, the days are now numbered. They're numbered. The tide is turning. People are finding, I found out about this 7 months ago. I did my research into FM World. Know anything about MLM? I'd seen her. She, the lady I'm talking about who sells Tropic now, I'm not sure if she was selling Tropic. Back then she might have been still with Arbonne, I'm not sure. I'd seen her and I was, harmless, isn't it? Harmless, isn't it? I know more about it now and it's not harmless. Suzanne, it's not harmless. The ladies who sell your products are ladies who go around telling everyone about their wellness. I do wellness. They are the ladies that turn up to barbecues and people give each other sideways glances. They are the ladies whose friends talk about them getting involved with a pyramid scheme behind their backs. And yeah, they're like pyramid schemes. That's the ladies. They're the ladies that secretly have money troubles but don't want anybody to know about it because they're too embarrassed, right? They're the ladies who are trying to make a few extra quid for their families, you know, treats, and they're losing money. All the time that could be spent selling your overpriced products that wouldn't compete in any normal marketplace. You know, they could be doing their own businesses. They could be learning a new skill. They could be joining clubs, book clubs, any kind of clubs. Or not Osborne, is it? But that's it. You cannot escape the reality of your chosen business model. You can't escape it. You cannot escape what it means. Now you can say until you are blue in the face, my MLM is different. Every MLM is different. Every MLM has a different con. And I notice on here, Talented Ladies Club, when we asked Tropic why their business plan was not publicly available, this was their explanation. We don't tend to share our success plan publicly as it can be misconstrued. What is that even supposed to mean? How can it be? How can it be misconstrued? Who cares if it is misconstrued? You'd surely have a Q&A. Or people would make inquiries, and if it had been misconstrued, go, oh no, that's, you know. MLM companies in the US have to share their success plan publicly by law. However, this law is not in place in the UK because MLM companies are rife in America and have been for a lot, lot longer. In the UK, law hasn't caught up. There's law for a reason. It's not law in the UK, you know. It's important to note that many other MLMs, such as Arbonne, are international. So you even know that you've got the same target market as Arbonne. You even know that. You're international, that's why they publicise this. So, publicise, where's the transparency? As 90% of our ambassadors are at ambassador level and aren't building businesses, we don't feel it's relevant to share publicly. We don't feel it's responsible to share earning promises as a product-based business. The last thing we want is for ambassadors to quit their jobs. I mean, this is the same bullshit as I heard from another owner of a company, and that's why now I have a policy. I don't speak to any owners of companies now. If an owner of a company, I made the mistake once, if an owner of a company wants to speak to me, it's no. It's no. No, 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 no. That's why I won't ever speak to you, Suzanne, because all you're going to do, and all any owner of a business is going to do, is attempt to justify the injustifiable. That's all you're going to do. You want to protect your business. You want to protect this business model. When the reality is, it's a destructive business model. And all this crap. You know what? This is the same thing as the other person told me when I asked for an income disclosure. Same thing. Give it a realistic expectations. It's nonsense. It's because you know, Suzanne, you know that if you showed how absolutely ridiculous this is, if you showed how little people were earning, and it would be little, wouldn't it? I bet they're not even earning anything, that 90%. I bet they're not even breaking even because, you know, they will buy products because it's wellness, isn't it? They have to buy products to do their parties and to do their this, that and the other and to take them to the barbecues where everyone does the sideway glances and smirks, right? They will be buying products. I mean, just this 200 fee, 25% commission. How many products they've got to sell to make that back? Before they've even broken even. And then there's all the products they have to buy for themselves. I bet they're not even breaking even. The majority of that 90%, are they, Suzanne? And if that's the case, then you do not have a business. You have a scam. You have a scam, Suzanne. I'm sorry if you don't like to hear that, but that is the reality. It does not matter how good your products are, right? It does not matter how happy everybody in your MLM says that they are, because everybody in every MLM says they're happy, right? It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. You are not transparent, and there's a reason for that. You know what that reason is, and it's because that 90%, the 90% are earning sod all, right? And if you want to join Tropic, you are going to earn sod all, because Suzanne won't even tell you how much of sod all you're going to earn, because she knows that you'll never join if she tells you. She knows that you'll laugh. You'll just get this ridiculous. You'll try Arbonne, maybe. Maybe you'll go for Temple Spa. Who knows? You know? But that's the reality of Tropic. And that's the reality for you, Suzanne. Right, you've chosen a predatory business model because you know it's the only way that you can make your business work. And that's not a slight on your product. I've heard only good things about your product, but they still doesn't mean they can compete in a normal marketplace. And if they can't compete in a normal marketplace and you have to go down a predatory business model, right? You don't have a business, you have a scam. You just have a scam with good products, right? If you have made content that Suzanne doesn't like, what Suzanne is now going to do is attempt to manipulate you into her way of thinking. She is going to be lovely to you. She's going to be a very nice person. So I don't doubt on a human level she is. And this is why I've decided now I won't be speaking to any more bosses of companies, company owners, because it's always the same thing. The version of me that will end up on the phone or Zoom or whatever to a company owner is not the logical version. It's the emotional version. And when the emotional version of you, and this is to anyone who's created content, when the emotional version of you is talking to that company owner, you will, well, they're lovely, aren't they? They're nice, it wouldn't hurt anyone. But that you cannot think like that, because I'm going to tell you now, Suzanne knows what she's doing and she's going to fight like hell to protect that. She wants you to get rid of your content. So that's what she's doing. She's going around asking you all to get rid of your negative content. Who does that? Would Clinique, would Nivea go on websites and request people took down negative reviews? Of course not. Of course not. In fact, I think that's probably one of the most unprofessional things I've ever heard in my life from a business. Ever. That somebody would do that. And that just, to me, do you know what that feels like? Do you know what that kind of feels like? I said it on my interview with Sean. It's these kind of mafiosa style kind of takedowns. People like, can you take that down, please? And it's not doing it in a nasty way, she'll do it in a manipulative way. Like, I'm so lovely. I just, my skincare brand, I just want to help people. But it's the same thing. Take it down. Take your bad review down, because I don't like it. That's all this is about. This won't be going down. And I welcome anybody who has been a Tropic Ambassador to please get in touch with me. You will be completely and utterly anonymous. But I've told you what's happening. Suzanne Maher is telling people to take down bad reviews about Tropic because she doesn't want anybody to learn of the pitfalls. She doesn't want anybody to know this might be a bad idea because it jeopardises her business, right? Please get in touch with me. Make a fake profile on Facebook. I don't need to know your name. Make a fake profile, right? And send me tell me your story. Tell me what happened to you, right? Because this won't be my last video now. I'm going to make more Tropic videos, right? More Tropic videos are coming. Suzanne.